Namaste, beautiful friends. This is a tutorial on the transition between mountain and cat. And really, it's four parts. It's from cat, mountain lift, then mountain. And from mountain, it's going down cat tuck. And then we go into cat again. I'm gonna show that first. So, from cat, we have the alignment, lower back neutral, so it's not hanging, it's not rounding, it's neutral. And in cat, the upper back is in a little back bend. It's not collapsing, it's not neutral, it's like a little cobra. So from cat, the next pose is mountain lift. And in mountain lift, the sit bones get stretched far back, the heels get pushed down, and what is lifted is our chest and our head. And then the next pose is mountain, where we have that mountain shape, or triangle shape between the torso, the legs, and the mat. The next pose is cat tuck, which is this pose. It's all, every vertebra is tucked in. So the tailbone is tucked in, your chin is tucked in, and every vertebra in between is tucked in. And the next pose is back cat. Lower back neutral, upper back in a back bend. So we have these four poses that we have in the transition. Let's see how we flow from one pose to the other. From cat into mountain lift. We go lifting the knees, the heels push back, the sit bones up, and this is mountain lift. From mountain lift into mountain, we lower vertebra by vertebra from the base to the crown. So first your lumbar, then your thoracic. Then your cervical, the last is your head. Ears in one line with the upper arm. Let's have a look at the next transition from mountain into cat tuck. Here, we curl the chin in at the same time as the heel push back. We round the chest, we tuck the tailbone. When the shoulders are over the wrists, we bend the knees. And then we lengthen from cat tuck back into cat. Good. I show it flowing. From cat, mountain lift. From mountain lift into mountain. From mountain into cat tuck. From cat tuck into cat. And the breath could be exhaling, mountain lift, mountain. Inhaling, cat tuck, cat. Or we add extra breath. Exhaling, mountain lift, in mountain. Ex cat tuck, in cat. Mountain lift, mountain, ex cat tuck, in cat, if you have tight posterior leg muscles, it's very hard to get this steep mountain feeling here. So if these hamstrings are tight, often we see round bags like that. But primary alignment in mountain is the straight spine. So to release this tightness in the legs, bend your knees to create that long spine from the sit bones to the crown. Then when you come into cat tuck, you go rounding your neck, pushing your heels back, rounding your thoracic, your lower back, then bending the knees, and then lengthen from the base. I show it once more. To go back and to keep that straight spine for tight posterior thigh muscles, please bend your knees. Create that straight spine for mountain lift, then relax into mountain. To come out into cat tuck, you round, push the heels back, neck, chest, lower back, bend the knees, and then lengthen from the base. If you want to gradually open then these tight posterior thigh muscles, you go mountain lift, mountain, and you can do mountain heel breath, gradually opening the back of your leg. And coming back, cat tuck, cat. Releasing into child, child asana. And rolling up into natural seat. I hope this tutorial helps you. There is another tutorial on cat and cat tuck, which I advise you to practice first. Once you manage cat and cat tuck and get more subtlety into that movement, the movement mountain cat is easier. And be patient with yourself. It's about getting more subtle each time we practice. Certain parts of the body need to open, which are maybe at the moment not open. But this is why we practice, to open the body, to create more energy flow, more flexibility, and more strength. Namaste. Enjoy.